self-confident, but it wasn't very benign at all. She was just, she and the daughter were complaining with this, and she created what she called a babel. She expressed surprise and delight and said, oh, I've made a babel. And she then started reminiscing about favorite foods and times when she made babels for the family. Babels are pretty big in Canada. And then they started talking about gardening. She tried to draw a picture of sweet. She loved that flower. So then her daughter said, a relaxed, happy it's time that helped her, the family, have this meaning of a smooth, fresh sharing. So it wasn't all about the symptoms and problems in the body. They were, so that's what our therapy can do. It sort of helps people to restore a sense of, I can do this. I can still be creative. And that's why I moved into art therapy, because my husband had cancer and fortunately survived the treatment. But I was with art therapists to get support. So I didn't really talk about it. As a social worker and counselor, I got an office with me. When I discovered art therapy, it just opened up a whole new world of being able to create and make things. And it's not shaping your world. People sometimes cut up magazine, jewelry, and scissors, and create a collage. And it's as if they're putting themselves back together. Does that make sense?
It does. It really does.
And actually, it takes you into another realm.